Good afternoon. I'm glad you're here. In 1619, slavery began in the USA. Abolitionists and Quakers were instrumental in helping slaves escape from the South to the North. The Underground Railroad was the most important way out of slavery leading up to the Civil War. Not a literal railway. The Underground Railroad was a network of people and places that offered refuge and legal aid to runaway slaves. Escapees hopped on and off as they made their way to free states and Canada. In this afternoon's performance, I will be playing music based on the coded spirituals that runaway slaves used to outwit their masters and elude capture. Some of the songs were related to Bible text. It's important to note that the church was the center of the Negro's communal experience. Slaves were forbidden to learn to read and write, so singing songs were a way for slaves to communicate. Masters didn't grasp that their illiterate slaves were singing coded messages. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. I looked over Jordan, and what did I see? Coming for to carry me home, a band of angels coming after me, coming for to carry me home.
Thank you.
decoded meaning of this song, Swing Low. Translate, underground railroad conductors are coming from the north to the south to help slaves escape. Sweet Chariot translates into a heavenly vehicle for escape. Be alert, ready to leave. Coming for to carry me home equals coming to take me to a free state or Canada. I looked over Jordan and what did I see? The Jordan River meant the Mississippi or Ohio River. These rivers were borders to free states. A band of angels coming after me. Translates, members of the Underground Railroad are coming to take me to freedom. An important person of the railroad was John Parker. He was an African-American abolitionist that, along with Elijah Anderson, worked out of Ripley, Ohio. Parker had purchased his own freedom in 1845 and later became a foundry owner. These two men brought 20 to 30 slaves at a time out of Kentucky. Way in the water. Wade in the water, children. Wade in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. The coded meaning for this one, while escaping and attempting to get to the next relay point on the railroad, make sure that you wade through water to throw the bloodhounds off your scent. Thank you. when an escape was made, you had to be clever and clandestine when you ran. A slave was valuable property, and a slave owner paid money for an escapee's return. Anywhere from 20 to 125 for each. In today's money, that's 350 to 3,000. With the protection of the Fugitive Slave Law and the Fugitive Slave Act, it was a lucrative business to catch runaway slaves and return them to their owner. People would use bloodhounds to gather the scent of an escapee, but when a person walks through water, their scent dissipates and makes it difficult for the dogs to find it. Another figure of the railroad, Isaac Tatum Hopper. He's one of the first Quakers and abolitionists whose life was dedicated to freeing slaves. Quakers felt compelled to be truthful to their beliefs that it was morally wrong to enslave a human. Quoting from Bound for Canaan, when he's concealing a fugitive in his home, I suspected that slave hunters were lurking about. He hired a black man to run out of the house after dark. As Hopper suspected, several men leaped from the shadows and seized the decoy while the real fugitive escaped out the back door and eventually to safety. Hopper even succeeded in having the decoy's assailants arrested for assault. Fugitives generally seem to have been sent on by foot and unaccompanied, and they were sometimes conducted on horseback across the countryside or transported from place to place hidden in farmers' market wagons. Disguises were also used to confuse pursuers. Excerpt from Bound for Canaan. The next piece I'll perform will be Deep River, but before I will acknowledge another major figure. William Still was born in 1821 as a free person in New Jersey. Mostly self-educated, he became one of the most successful businessmen in Philadelphia and a major go-to person of the railroad. He was one of those that helped Henry Box Brown out of his packing crate. Mr. Brown had had himself nailed shut inside a box, and that was shipped north to the Philadelphia anti-slavery office. With some water and biscuits, 27 hours later, he reached freedom, although part of the time in transit, he was upside down.
Thank you.
not all attempts were successful. And those that didn't make it, the punishment was often harsh. Even those that didn't make it were still under the threat of the Fugitive Slave Act, where if you were captured in a free state, you could be forced back into slavery. The interpretive meaning of "my home is over Jordan" is a longing to be free and escape by crossing the Ohio River. Jordan, the river, is from text in the Bible and would be referenced to the Ohio River, which borders a free state and freedom. Crossing over into campground, the coded meaning is crossing the river into a religious meeting place or campground for a meeting. Next is a spiritual medley featuring "Let My People Go" and "Michael, Row Your Boat Ashore." Harriet Tubman was a conductor, and she had serious respect for her courage and determination. Her nickname was Moses, and in a 15-year period, she made 19 trips and transported approximately 300 slaves from the South to the North into free states. She was no-nonsense, crude-talking, and carried a pistol. If someone wanted to give up, she would hold a gun toward their head and say, "You'll be free or die a slave." She and anyone she transported were never captured. Go Now Moses adopts a biblical story of Moses from the books of Exodus, and she would sing this song to alert her escapees of immediate danger. She was referred to as Moses going way down into Egypt's land, referring to the south, to tell old Pharaoh, "Let my people go," was referring to slave owners, "Let slaves go." "Michael, Row Your Boat Ashore" is not really a coded spiritual, but if you would like to sing along when I get there, please feel free.
Thank you.
Not all attempts to escape were successful. And those that didn't make it, punishment was often harsh. And even those that didn't make it were still under the threat of the Fugitive Slave Act, where if you were captured in a free state, you could be forced back into slavery. Couldn't hear nobody pray. Couldn't hear nobody pray. Way down yonder, by myself, couldn't hear nobody pray. Couldn't hear nobody pray. Couldn't hear nobody pray. In the valley, on my knees, couldn't hear nobody pray. Couldn't hear nobody pray. Couldn't hear nobody pray. Way down yonder, by myself, couldn't hear nobody pray. The lyric meaning for this is about an attempt escape that failed. A failed attempt meant a return to slavery and a financial reward for a bounty hunter. Punishment for running away could mean being whipped, chained, and in certain instances, death. Couldn't hear nobody pray, meaning a person was alone without aid, trying to make it to freedom. Way down yonder by myself could translate saying I was away from everyone else that may have made it. Chilly waters, referring to the cold water of a river. In the Jordan, referring to the Ohio River. Crossing over, referring to crossing from a slave state into Canaan, in biblical terms, a place for freedom. freedom was most important to a slave. And to those that were honest to the values in which this country is based upon, slavery was not acceptable. It violated the laws of the Constitution and the laws of God. However, it did take a war, the Civil War, to get rid of the institution that had been a way of life for many. I'd like to take a moment to thank Brooklyn Public Library and Meredith Walters and Greg Richards in their aid to making this happen. Also would like to thank John Gurren and Stephanie Griffin for additional audio and technical support. You'll be able to figure out the name of this last song I will perform. The melody for this piece came to me when I was leaving a particularly burdensome situation. Please appreciate your freedom and remember that many people have died so that you can be free.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for staying with me this afternoon. And it's my sincere wish to be able to perform for you at another time. Hopefully in a live setting. Okay. If you want to know more, I've got my latest recording available on Bandcamp called Spirituals, dedicated to this project. Thank you very much.